Hello students. Okay, now we'll solve one more question from question paper. It asked in January 15 for 9 marks. Okay, but the question is, they given processors, burst time and arrival time, and you have to draw Gantt chart and calculate the waiting time and turnaround time using FCFS, SJF and round robin with prime quantum 10 scheduling algorithm. Okay, let's see how to solve. Okay, first one. Okay, so these are the processors, burst time and arrival time. Okay, so how to draw Gantt chart FCFS? Okay, so you have to see first arrival time, which processes are arrived at time 0. That processes you have to start at time 0. So which process is arrived? P1. So P1 you have to start execute. Okay, in FCFS it is what? It's a non-preemptive. Okay, so it completely executes, it not stop in between. Okay, so it take full 10 millisecond to execute. Okay, so burst time is 10, it take full 10 millisecond to execute. Okay, after that, after 10 millisecond, so all other processes are arrived. Clear, no? Okay, so here in FCFS what? First come, first serve. Okay, clear, no? Okay, so here all other processes are arrived. So next process is P2. Okay, second process is P2 at time 1. Okay, so what is the burst time? 29, 10 to 39. After that, next P3. P3 how much? 3, 39 to 42. Then P4 is 7 burst time. Okay, 40 to 49. Clear, no? Okay. Then second one, SJF. SJF means what? Non-preemptive. Okay, so non-preemptive means what here? Okay. So it completely executes. When process starts, it completely executes. Okay. In SJF, what happens? Okay. So it's shortest job first. Which process having less burst time, that process execute. Here in the example, 3 is the shortest. Okay. But arrived at 2. Okay. But you can't start. Okay. So you have to start what? P1 first. Because at time 0, P1 is arrived here. Okay, even though P2, P3 burst time is less, you can't take because it arrived at time 3. Clear, no? It arrived at time 2. Okay, but before that P1 is already ready to execute. Okay, so CPU don't want to waste time. Okay, don't want to waste time, 2 milliseconds. Okay, so here P1 is ready to execute, so start execute. Okay, so here in SJF, start execute. Okay, in non-preemptive what happens? It completely executes. Okay, and after that at time 10, okay, at time 10 all processes are ready. At time 10, okay, all processes are ready. So now it sees which is the less burst time. So 3 is the less burst time, so it execute P3, okay, for 3 milliseconds. After that 3, next to 7, no? 7 burst time is next. So it execute P4. So it execute P4 for 7 millisecond. Last one is P2. Okay. So 29. 22, 49. Clear, no? Okay. Next round robin. Okay. Round robin. Here time quantum is how much? 10. Okay. Time quantum is 10. Okay. So here which process arrived at time 0? P1 only. So P1 it execute, okay, for 10. Okay, the time quantum is 10, no? So it execute 10. Even the burst time also 10, no? So it execute full. Okay, it completes its execution. Okay, so it completes its execution. This execution over. Next at time 10 all processes arrived. Okay, so it it execute in order only, like FCFS, it execute in order only. Okay, so here P2, how much burst time is 10. Okay, what is the quantum time? 10. Okay, it execute only for 10 milliseconds. Okay, out of 29. Okay, so 19 is remain. Out of 29, 19 is remain. So it execute for what? 10 milliseconds. Okay, 10 to 20. Okay, so what is, how much time is remain? 19 is remain. Okay, then after that P3, what is the burst time? 3. Okay, so here even the quantum is 10. Okay, the burst time is 3 only. So it execute only 3 milliseconds. P3, it execute from 20 to 23. Okay, next to P4. So P4 is 7 milliseconds. Burst time is 7 milliseconds. Okay, so it execute 7 milliseconds, 23 to 30. Okay, after that, so even this also completed, no? Even this is also completed. Even this also completed. Which is remain, no? P2. Okay, so P2. So quantum time is 10, no? So it execute only 10. Okay, out of 19, 10 is remain, 9 is remain. Okay, it is 30 to 40. Then again, all other processes are already completed. So 9 is remain. Okay, P2 burst time 9 is remain. So it execute 40 to 49. Clear, no? Okay. Then, so it also asks to find waiting time. Okay. It also asks calculate waiting and turnaround time using all three. Okay. Now you have to find waiting time of FCFS. Okay. What is the waiting time of FCFS have you find? Okay. Process P1. Okay. What is the waiting time in FCFS method? P1, how much time it wait? 0. Okay. Then P2, how much time it wait? 10 minus. Okay. When it is arrived? At time 1. Okay. Process P1 arrived at time 0 only. So, burst time is 10. Arrival time is 0. 10 minus 0 is. It arrived at time 0. No. Okay. So, arrival time is 0. Okay, it not wait for anything. Then P2, waiting time is how much? Yeah, 10 is there, but arrived at 1. So 10 minus 1 is 9. Okay, what about P3? P3 arrived, when you start execute at 39, but when it is arrived at time 2, so 39 minus 2, 37. Clear, no? Next to P4, when you start execute 42, when it is arrived 3, so 42 minus 3 get 39. Clear, no? Okay, then SJF. Okay, what is the waiting time of P1? Is 0. Okay, it arrived at 0 only, so it not wait for any execution, so immediately start execute. What about P1, P2? Okay, it arrived at 10, no? It arrived at 1. Okay, when you start to execute 10, P2 here, no? 20. Okay, so 20, when you start execute at time 20. Okay, what is the arrival time? 1. So 20 minus 1, so you get 19. Then P3 is 10. When it is arrived, P3 at time 2. P3 arrived at time 2. Okay, so here 10 minus 2 is 8. Okay, then last two, P4 at time 13, no? Okay, at time 13, when it is arrived at time 3, 13 minus 3, you get 10. Simple, no? Okay, next last two, time round robin. Okay, when it is arrived at time 0. Okay, so 0 minus 0. Then what about P2 is 30, no? Okay, or no, 40. So here, how much time it wait to P2? So here, 10, no? Okay. Then here, it wait for 10 milliseconds. But when it is arrived P2? P2 arrived at 2. Okay. So 10 minus 2, 8. Okay, it execute. Then here 3. 3, 8, 11, 11, 7, 18, 18, okay, so it wait 18, clear how it got 18, no? Okay, so here P2 wait 10 millisecond here, okay, minus arrival time is 2, so 10 minus 2 is 8, okay, then it execute, okay, then 8 plus 3, 11, 11 plus 7, 18, okay, P2 wait 18 millisecond, clear, no? Then P3 wait 18 millisecond. P2 19 over, no? P3, no? P3 here. P3, when it is arrived? P3 arrived at time 2, no? So here 8 minus 2, 8. 8 plus 3, 11, 11 plus 7, 18. So here 18, no? You get 18, correct. Then last P4, how much time it wait? When it is arrived at time 3. So 23 minus 3. Okay, 20. So 20 is the answer. Clear, no? Then time, turnaround time. Okay. How you find turnaround time? Waiting time plus burst time. Okay. What is the waiting time of first FCFS? No. Waiting time is 0. 0 plus 10. You get 10. You know, no? Turnaround time. Okay. Waiting time plus BT. Okay. You just add waiting time plus BT. Okay. Then waiting time of P2 is 9. Burst time is 29. Okay, so burst time is 29. Okay, 9 plus 29, you get 38. Okay, next 37 plus 3, you get 40. Next 39 plus 7, so you get 46. Clear, no? So like this, you have just go on add. Okay. Waiting time plus burst time. See the waiting time, then add burst time. Like this, you can calculate. Clear, no? Okay. If they ask to find average, you just add all those things, then divide by 4. Clear, no? Okay. Even waiting time also. Add all the waiting time, divide by 4. Clear, no? Okay. Thank you.